Anybody familiar with using little tiny amps in the studio will attest to how effective they are in making very big tones. All you got to do is ask Jimmy Page or Joe Walsh or, you know, someone from the 70s. They just sound great. So I've assembled a preset, an 18 preset of 8 little amps, and I've done this before, but since firmware 16 has appeared and most of these have been revised, all of the ones on this preset have been revised, I thought I'd write it again and share it with you so you could have some fun too. This is a Fender 70th anniversary Esquire, completely stock. And all right, so that was scene one that you just heard. Let's get straight into it. Based on the Swart Atomic Space Tone, and of course, Swart Atomic Space Tone is a registered name. These are not endorsed by the companies as far as I know, but I've just put them in there so you know what you're dealing with in the scenes. Great, really crisp, fresh kind of top end. So, somebody said it might have been Yek actually, that it's sort of like a mixture between an AC30 and a Princeton kind of thing, and it really is. So in the effects lineup here, you've got a drive. And the drive I've chosen for this one is the old face fuzz. We've got a bit of delay, which for all of the scenes is the same, stereo tape delay. We've got my rotary block, which is controlled by controllers, so you've got an automatic brake up and down, fast and slow. We've got the phaser, which is the FAS vibe. Couple that with the face fuzz. Lots of fun. If you want a tremolo, it's there too. And the chorus, the good old analog. Stereo chorus. So that's the effects. We've done that now. That's cool. We'll go back to scenes. Scene two. And I'll just turn that off because I'm going to export this after I finish the video so you can have a shot of it. So there you go. The Swart Atomic Tone. Scene two is the 5F1 Tweed. Little champ. In case you're wondering, this switch is a three-way. All the way to the back basically defeats the tone control, so you've just got the broadcaster pickup going straight, a Esquire pickup rather, going straight to the amp. I like it in the middle that brings in the tone. You've just got a little bit tamer top end. And over here is the strangle switch, which is great for lead stuff, but I'm not going to use it today. 501 Tweed, yes, the Champ. And again, you can bring in, you know, any of those effects. Sounds absolutely huge for a tiny weeny amp. That is the face fuzz again. And of course, all of these other effects should suit it as well, like the rotary. Scene 3 is the AC20, the Morgan AC20 EF86 treble channel. And the drive for it is the old 808. Love that sound. Scene 4, the Deluxe Tweed 5E3. That sag, that front end sag, it's a killer. Stick the drive in front. The 808. But, you know, if you wanted to, you could go the face fuzz. Again, it will benefit from the rotary. And all the delay. They're just such great sounding amps, especially in firmware 16. Thank you, Cliff. I can't say that enough. Thank you, thank you, thank you. The Princeton Reverb. The drive that I have associated with it is another version of the 808, just a little bit more drive and a little bit less level, and I've wound the tone back a bit because the Princeton is already pretty steely. Where were we? Scene 6, the Supro. Such a cool sound, a very different sound. It sounds, reminds me of cardboard for some reason. It's something about the texture of it. That's a killer, isn't it? I think so. Scene 7. 62 Vibrolux. The Mark Knopfler Dire Straits amp. Classic Fender tone. Brown face. Only made between 61 and 63, I think. Again, we'll benefit from the drives of all of the effects. And that, of course, is the face fuzz, but we can go to the tube screamer. And finally, the scene 8, the Blues Junior. And the Blues Junior with the fat channel on and the master volume wound up for this tone. Not even sure if that's what they used on that recording, but it sounds pretty good to me. Probably this amp, the Deluxe Tweed. Back to the Blues Junior. Drive. How good's that little 5F1? Because it's got that bottom end, and it's a little tiny amp, because it's got that bottom end, really good with the rotary. If only I knew what I was playing. Anyway, there you go. Burg's Little Guys Firmware 16 or version 2. Have fun with it. See you soon. Thank you for watching. And thank you, Cliff and Fractal Audio Systems, for creating such amazingly creative and inspiring tools. I'll shut up. Goodbye.